Christians, but also Yeah, wow. Just to lifted because his desire is. Then we are just in prayer, we have nothing. Then pray for the meeting. Amen. We have earlier next 6 months Sundays, but it's not all Sundays, only 4 Sundays in the 6 months. The programming is studies that be online out of the 6 months. Maybe the last one count, so it'll be institution.
Contrary to you, oh God, are busy in the things that you do not approve, oh Heavenly Father. Lord, you've given us grace and mercy, Lord, that we can come and be in your house.
Amen.
Heavenly Father, we want to appreciate your holy name. We want to lift your name on high, Lord. We want to worship you, Lord, for there is none other who is worthy to be worshipped, Lord, except you, oh Heavenly Father. Lord Jesus, as we come to this solemn moment, Father God, we pray, may you look beyond all our faults, may you look beyond all our weaknesses, oh God. Father God, where we might have sinned against thee throughout the week, Lord, we pray. May you forgive us, Lord. May you wash us, Lord, as white as snow. Heavenly Father, as you've come to be saved, Lord, we pray. May you be the singer of the songs of Zion, Lord. Father God, may you anoint the brother who stood before us, oh God. Heavenly Father, that is ye sing the songs of Zion, Lord, Heavenly Father. May your spirit be upon you, oh Heavenly Father. Lord, I even pray for the preaching of the word, oh God. Heavenly Father, I pray may you use the name of God, Lord, to speak to us, oh Heavenly Father. May you come, Lord, use him just as an instrument, oh God. Father God, we want to pray for the prayer requests that we've had, oh God. Father God, some are caught up in Nigeria, Almighty Jesus, Heavenly Father, with these travel restrictions, oh God. Heavenly Father, we know that you can make a way where there seems to be no way, Lord. Heavenly Father, may you make a way for them, oh Heavenly Father. Lord, we want to pray for Caleb, Lord, who's not feeling well. Lord, we pray, may you touch him, oh Heavenly Father. We pray, oh God, even for Brother Mike. Lord, you know he's asked desires, Lord, may you continue to touch him and heal him, oh Heavenly Father.
Yes.
Lord, we want to pray, Lord, even for all those who are not in service, Lord. Those that are joining on streaming, oh God, some are studying, oh God, and failed to make it for service. Heavenly Father, I pray, may you be with them, Lord. May we be in the same spirit, oh God. Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord. May you start with us and finish with us. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Oh, there's a name I have to give. That's so, amen. There is a name I love to hear. I love to sing its words. It sounds like music in my ear. The sweetest name on earth. Hallelujah, oh, how I love to turn.
Thank you. Thank you. Amen.
From one level to the next level. Amen. Amen. From glory unto glory. Amen. Blessing, they shall be showered with blessings. Amen. This is the promise of God. Amen. There shall be showers of blessing. This is the promise of God. There shall be seasons refreshing sent from the Savior above. Showers of blessing. Showers of blessing with me. Mercy drop from the stars and for the showers with me. Challenges or anything that the devil is trying to put upon us, oh God, we pray and ask, oh God, to remove all such things, Almighty God, and hide everything, Lord Almighty, before thee, Father. Lord, if there be some things, Father God, that we are unwittingly or unknowingly or unaware of doing, which is not right before thee, oh God, we pray that the body was fired with a fire and expose it, Father, that it can come to our knowledge. Father, that we can depend on us, oh God. Our desire is to be Almighty God, King before thee. We know out of our own righteousness, there is none, Father, but we live the righteousness of God. But we also pray that you make our path and our lives, oh God Almighty, such that Almighty God will walk in the integrity and sincerity of our hearts, yielding our life, knowing, oh God, that we are Almighty God's Savior. We ask this believing, oh God, in the name of our Lord and Savior. Amen and amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
God, thank you, Lord, for your presence and Jesus.
Amen. Amen.
I like to greet you again. In the name of the Savior, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
You can be seated, my sister. Amen. I appreciate your piano. Amen. We're currently going through a series, and that's October. Patient is still upon my heart. And I just thought maybe if we are going forward, okay, when God is coming forward, I mean, to end the inspiration, but who knows, maybe the inspiration. We're talking, it came back from on the former and the today. Today is the continuation of the inspiration. We just want to go with the flow, because sometimes we may insist of you want to go for the much. I'm one person that doesn't want to topic things. I just want to stay there and lean as much as possible that the Lord has given us.
Amen.
So I was saying to read about the Bible. Unfortunately, again, I left that completely depend upon the man. Depend upon God giving it. Amen. On the minor prophet here. Amen. That's where we read our main scripture from. It's only 3 verses. This one. Waiting for you to come to this. Amen. 10:36. This one. We're talking about the former and that. Amen. We believe that when it is raining, rain is bringing blessings. Amen. Hallelujah. All right. Come and let us return unto the Lord. He has come and he will hear. He has smitten and he will bind us up. After 2 days, will he revive us? Of course, there. That 1 day before the Lord is 1,000 years, and those 2 days, if we took our prophecies, it's been the last 2,000 years. Amen. So when we're coming towards the 3rd day, which we trust and believe, we are now currently in the 3rd day. We are expecting now that we will receive the blessings of the 3rd day. And in the 3rd day, you will raise us up and we shall live. Then we shall know if we follow on, know the Lord. His going forth is prepared as the morning, and he shall come unto us as the rain, in the latter, in the former rain upon us. For that is the reading of the question we pray. Mighty God, Father, we have read your word. Any man who has gone to school and taught Father is able it's more than a man, but being the interpretation level. Lord, we just give my life, Lord, use everything, oh God, unto you. May Lord, may you also speak to me as we speak on this way. May you yourself and be blessed. May we see it. I will quickly pray. We kept for the sake of understanding what they are aware of, what we're talking about. But our sermons are online, 2 sermons. Amen. So when you're talking about the former and the latter way, now we're talking about the former and the latter way. This aspect, because I want to mention something. In talking about the former and the latter rain, we realize that there are seasons for the former rain and there are seasons for the latter rain.
Amen.
The season for the former rain is the rain that comes up in October. We're talking about the land of Israel. So that rain comes so slowly. And the farmers who are farming know when they see that rain come, they quickly go to the ground and prepare the ground and take in the seed. Amen. And then the rain goes, and then sometimes it comes in between. And then towards the February, March, you have the latter rain. Now the latter rain, when it comes to bring the crop, which is now grown to a certain stage, it is almost up to maturity, to give it its last growth sprout. Amen? So when that latter rain comes, the crops now are able to be endured with enough moisture in the correct environment for them to go through for another sprout. Amen. And to ripen. Amen. The seed, when it is ripened, that letter rain goes. Amen. And then the sun comes. Amen. And when the sun comes, it comes to make sure that the seed is ripened. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And then the harvest. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's often the process of farming with the rains. Amen. But God promised us, amen, that when it comes to the latter rain, amen, He's not only going to send us the latter rain only. He's going to send the former and the latter rain. Amen. So in the second season of February, March, we are going with the seasons. Amen. God promised that he's not only going to send rain, which is like drinking. Former rain is just soft rain. He's going to send the former rain and the latter rain. Amen. So there will be a double portion. Amen. And we know that the church always seems to be a double portion. With Elijah, we went to be with the Lord after the children had caught him up. He threw his garment on, and Elijah caught it. And Elijah was the type of the church. Elijah was the type of Jesus Christ. And the church had this garment, the second hand rope. And when the church had the second rope, it does things in a double portion. Amen? God has always wanted the church of the living God to do greater than he did himself. Not in quality, but in quantity. Amen. So we have been called and with a high expectation to have more than what Christ did in the flesh. Amen. And Christ is doing that. Hallelujah. You know what I mean? This, because we've got more in number, so we are also doing more. Amen. But brother, sister, do not be left behind by not having your own testimony of being more than what Christ did. Amen. There is an expectation within you that you have been given the ability within you, the potential laid within you, if you believe in the word of God, to have the life of Jesus Christ and to have more in quantity than it is.
Amen.
Do not ever have an unbelief about that. I've always believed that. Amen. It may not come in one day, but over the course of your pilgrimage, amen. Over the course of your lifetime, amen. As you are young and you are growing, amen. Know that yesterday's testimony was a build up to tomorrow's testimony, amen. Of what Christ is doing in your life. It's not you that is doing it, but it's the same Christ that is doing it in your life. Amen. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. So we've got that same inspiration. Amen. And then we went on to speak about how in Job 2 we've been given the promise of the latter rain now to the church. Amen. Now, the promise of the latter rain now to the church came in this manner. For the day of Pentecost, amen, when the church was being inaugurated on the day of Pentecost and started, God said the Holy Ghost to start the church, amen?
Amen.
And after the church was started by the presence of God coming himself to divide himself among the scattered 20, the church started doing the works of Christ, amen? As they were doing the works of Christ, the people that had thought that they would kill Jesus and they laid him in the grave. So and behold, started seeing the very same life of Jesus Christ being lived out and expressed within certain individuals that had walked with him. Amen. The likes of Peter, John, hallelujah, and Mark, and so on and so forth. Amen. They were seeing this life. They could see that the shadows were healing people. Their garments were healing people. Just like amen. Then when you see that the sick were being used, the dead were being resurrected, the signs and the wonders were being multiplied. They thought they done it all in killing Jesus. Amen. But they didn't realize they made a way for that seed of Christ itself to be planted, hallelujah, in the heart of the believers. Amen. And what planted in the heart of Jesus to multiply and produce much more. Amen. At Antioch, we were called Christian.
Amen.
They never report any other name. Amen. The church of the living God has never had a name. Amen. They were called Christians because Christ was living in them. And Christians are the people that follow Jesus Christ. And still remain the same. Amen. The church of the living God has no other name than being called Christians. Amen. We go by the term of spiritual bed or whatever we might call ourselves for the legality of being registered. But we are not really people that are claimed that we are favored based fellowship or or any other name, amen. This is just an identity for us to have a location with us in these countries, amen, or in other places. If you are asked, are you a believer? Are you a Christian? Would you say that I go to favored base? No. You say, I'm a believer. If you ask, are you a believer? We say, I'm Baptist, amen. That's what you're not of Christ because you are claiming yourself to a church. Amen. You should never claim yourself to the church, but you should claim yourself to the person of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Now in John, we hear that this former rain was also promised in the last day. Amen. In the last day, after the church was inaugurated, Paul came and as he was teaching his gospel. Amen. It was the moderate aim to teach him prayer. Hallelujah. The church needs that. And if you ever want to start a church like what we are doing here, or what other places are doing, you have to start. Amen. Because you cannot go on a gospel without a teaching. You cannot go on a gospel without a doctrine. You cannot go on a gospel without your conviction, without the seed, word of God being laid in your heart and in the heart of the believers following you. Because what you are planting, amen, is going to produce of its own kind. Amen. If you are planting the seed, word of God, you will get the seed, word of God, of other Christians coming into the fellowship, not for the sake of just joining the fellowship, but receiving the seed, word of God. That is what we want. Amen. The word of God to be multiplied among us. Amen. Glory to Almighty God. As the teaching then went forth, in Joel we have the promise. Amen. I'll just quickly go through it. Joel 2, verse 18. And I've got inspiration on my sideline. Amen. This is just a recap. I hope God will give my grace to you. Quickly get my inspiration. Amen. The Lord will be just faith. For if then the pity people here, the Lord will answer and say unto you, for behold, I'll send you coin and wine and oil. I love it because on our previous message, he says that coin represents the bread, one mention of revelation, and oil represents the Holy Ghost. Amen. And we have been promised in Deuteronomy chapter 14 that I will give you the day in your land. Amen. Sorry, I'm just quickly going through this. I don't have time to catch up, but I'll give you the size, God willing. Amen. Then I'll give you the rain of your land in these two seasons. The first rain in the latter rain. The first rain being the former rain, and the latter rain being the second rain. That you may gather in thy corn, thy wine, and thy oil. Now, the purpose of God giving us the former and the latter rain is this. He wants us to gather. Hallelujah. The corn. He wants us to have wine. He wants us to have oil. He wants us to have the bread of life. He wants that bread of life to come with the simulation of revelation that God only himself can give. No man can give revelation. And the wine. Hallelujah. So in Joel 2, the Lord says, I will send you the coin, the wine, and the oil. You shall be satisfied. We need the word of God to satisfy us with their way. And I'll no more be a reproach among the brethren. Amen. So that coin, that wine, that oil takes away the reproach. What is the reproach among the brethren? When people look upon the Christian, they are not expecting to see you. They're expecting to see Christ in you, in you. Amen. So if you don't produce Christ in you, they'll say, ah, you think you're a Christian. Where is the roots of Christ? Or you think you're a Christian? Where are the fruits of Christ? Or you think you're a Christian, or you're a church of the living God, where are the signs and the wonders that Christ teaches? Amen. People have got an expectation that we are due to give them the life of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. And that is the expectation that the world is looking after. The moment you step up forward and you say you're a Christian, you put yourself under public domain to exhibit Christ. Amen. And the reason why this gospel of Christianity they don't reach as far as they got to hell is because there was a false presentation of Christ that went ahead. And that false presentation of Christ, which we shall speak later, is then what made people to save. This is the life. I said the other day, from Zimbabwe, where we come from, if people are not producing the life of Jesus Christ, they're going to wickedness. And then it does not rain. And then you hear people saying, I'm not saying I'm blessing an eye. They mean that because the people are living in such a shame and shame, the rain is not going to fall. Amen. But if the people are living right, hallelujah, the people have come back to the Lord, as the Hosea prophet was saying, if the people have turned and they've repented and they are crying out for pardon, amen, then the rain will come. And you hear them, they will see, they know this. They will say, let all of us gathering, let all of us gather together and pray for the rain. Amen. Why? Because you know that grace comes only if people are living right. If people have repented, hallelujah. Grace comes with the blessings. Amen. Hallelujah. Oh man, I just want to quickly get to where I want to. I will move far from you the northern army and will drive him into the garden and his face towards the sea, in the past towards the outpost sea, and his thing shall come up, and his himself shall come up because he has done great things. Amen. We will see what this Northern Army is all about.
Okay.
We are now in inspiration for our day service. Amen. I think some of you get up online of the other things that we said. He says, verse 21, fear not, O Lord. Be glad and rejoice. For the Lord will do great things. Amen. Be not afraid, you disobedient. For the pastors of the good that is spring, patches only spring when it is rained. Amen. For the tree, bears a fruit. Amen. The tree can only bear a fruit when it is rained. Amen. The fig tree and the vine give their strength. Be glad, then, you children of Zion, and rejoice in the Lord your God, for he has given you the former rain modernity. And he will cause to come for you the rain, the former and the latter rain in the first month. Amen. And the floor shall be full of wheat, and the fields shall overflow with wine and oil. Hallelujah. So there is the promise. This is the promise that Joel was proclaiming that it shall happen in the future. Amen. And the prophet said that this promise of Joel 2 was accomplished in 1906 in the Azusa Street. Amen. The outpouring of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Because that was the time when the Christians were gathering together. They wanted to see the life of Jesus Christ. They wanted to see what the disciples did. They wanted to have the same experience that the disciples did in the day of Pentecost. Amen. And they were crying out for the Holy Ghost. And God outpoured the Holy Ghost in fulfillment of Joel 2. Hallelujah. And in Joel 2, God was going to open up another area. It was the beginning of the Laodicean church age, but it was opening up another area. So the former and the latter rain was the promise of the Holy Ghost was going to come. Hallelujah. In the third day. And that was the beginning of the third day. I think 1906 is 100 years later, in 2021, almost 2022, 2000 years since elapsed with the Roman calendar, what more the Jewish calendar. Amen. We are far beyond 2022. We don't even know where exactly we are. Amen. Oh, glory to Almighty God. We are living in the day of the resurrection of Christ. Amen. The day of the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Christ goes on the third day, and he has promised that he's coming to us on the third day. Amen. We should never forget that we are believers of the end time message. Amen. We believe in the end time message. We believe we are coming to an end. We believe that Christ takes the bride, the only be 3.5 years left for this world. Amen. And those 3.5 years are allocated for Christ to bring with the truth. Amen. And after that, they will come and clean away all things. Amen. All things. They will come in a cleaning up the world. Imagine if this was to happen here. That would only mean that everything that we are planning for will not happen. How be it? We still have to plan for them because we don't know the hour or the day. Amen. Because it might not come this year, it might come in 10 years from now. Amen. But we live according to it, full of expectation that it might come. It wishes us now to get the blessings of getting the corn, the wine, and the oil. That is outpoured in this end. Amen. Glory to Almighty God. Amen. We go to another stage. Oh, I want to read. I can get it. Amen. Let's begin with the scripture reading in Joel. Amen. There's just an element which I really want to touch on. I don't have the slide there, but I want to read that scripture. Amen. Sometimes we end up adding a man for our time. But at the same time, we cannot just hurry without getting lightsick. Amen. Oh, man. Can somebody just need to be drawn back at verse 50? I want to continuation where we left off. I don't have my glass. Okay? Forget that. If I not got there, I'll paraphrase it. Amen. Joel himself was a minor prophet. Amen. He lived in the days of Elijah. Amen. Although the book of Joel is put across in one of the minor prophets, Jeremiah, and so forth. But he, according to the status of the time and era that he lived in the time and era of the days of Elisha. Amen? Amen. Remember we had Elijah, then Elisha, and along that side, along those sidelines, amen, there was, can somebody help me?
John chapter 2, 15.
Yeah, just leave 15, get to about 22 or something like that. That's from 22.
From 15 to 22, yeah?
No, start from 22.
From 22, okay. Be not afraid.
Start from 15.
Blow the trumpet in Zion. Sanctify a fast.
Amen.
Call a solemn assembly.
Amen.
Gather the people.
Amen.
Sanctify the congregation.
Amen.
Assemble the elders.
Amen.
Gather the children.
Amen.
And those that suck the breast. Let the bridegroom go forth on his chamber and the bride out of her closet.
Amen.
Let the priests, the ministers of the Lord, weep between the porch and the altar.
Amen.
And let them say, spare the people, O Lord, and give not thine inheritance. Reproach that the heathen should rule over them. Amen. Wherefore should they say unto the people, where is their God?
Amen.
Verse 18. Then will the Lord be jealous for his land and pity his people. Yea, the Lord will answer and say unto his people, behold, I will send you corn and wine and oil,
amen,
and you shall be satisfied therewith. Amen. And I will no more make you a reproach among the heathen.
Amen. So read this. Amen. Go on. There's something where I want to go.
But I will remove far off from you the northern army.
Okay. That's 1 second. Amen. Amen. So this is the scripture we're reading. I will remove far from you the northern army. Verse 23 says, be dead then into Zion. Rejoice in the Lord your God, for he has given you the former head mortally, and you will cause to come down the former and the latter head, and the floors shall be full of wheat, fat, and overflow with wine and oil. Amen. I wanted to just start on that former head and latter head. Amen. Glory to Almighty God. Still, there's something which I do not get. I'm going to go without this. Can you read the verse? Above, I just want to see the promise. Can you have a like? Donut. Not getting what I want. Man. Sorry for those opinions. Man. Amen. The song always says, amen. Maybe the Lord bless. In that particular scripture, I might not have it now. The Lord promised when he's promising the great things that you will do great things. Amen. The great things that he says you will do is that eventually is about the farmer of Israel.
No, before that.
Then go on before that.
Says, fear not, O land, and be glad and rejoice, for the Lord will do great things.
Amen. Go on.
Be not afraid, ye beasts of the field, mm-hmm, for the pastures of the wilderness do spring. For the tree beareth their fruit, the fig tree and the vine do yield their strength.
Okay, that's all. In verse 20, in verse 2, the psalm of well says that the you restore the common well.
Yes.
Then the locust.
25.
You know what? I've copied this onto my slide wrong. That's why I was saying there's something wrong. Yeah. Can you read verse 25? I was reading and I was saying something wrong. Can you read verse 25 for me?
And I will restore to you the years that the locust hath eaten, the cankerworm, and the caterpillar, and the palm worm, my great army which I sent among you.
Amen. So we have promised great things. Amen. That's all great things. Amen. And one of the great things is the restoration. Amen.
Amen.
That's what I want to get. Amen. That's our message today. The title and the inspiration too is the former rain and the latter rain. But in this former rain and the latter rain, there's a promise that goes alongside with this. Amen. The promise that goes alongside with this former rain and the latter rain that God includes with the last day is the restoration. Amen. The restoration is what the power will is eaten. What the locust is eaten. What the thunder will is eaten. And what the canker will is eaten. Amen. So that restoration is part and parcel of the great things. Amen. Because these people, if I was to just go to a court, let me just quote Branham here. Amen. Now, the process of all, like all other, in the message, Pamela, Locus, and the Caterpillar, like all other prophecies, has a compound meaning. A prophecy sometimes has a natural meaning, things happening, the prophecy is happening natural. There's a spiritual meaning. Now, of course, the natural meaning of that meaning, go to verse 25. Amen. Even Dr. Scofield in his footnotes. Now we put in that. I'm not a Scofield diet, meaning that it doesn't always go along with what Scofield says. Amen. However, in his footnotes there on that note, amen. He gives that it means when the sin is come over and he made it. Amen. Then the prophet says, that's true. Amen.
Amen.
So that's the thing that Scofield would say. That are not necessarily true. But on this note, Brother Branham says that when Scofield is talking about the natural invasion of Israel by the Syrian army, that was true in terms of the prophecy. Amen. But the prophecy was in twofold. Amen. It had a natural meaning and it also had a spiritual meaning. Now, for us that we want to find out what happens in the natural of Israel is what happens in the spiritual of the church. Amen. When we're going through the series, we talk about the Israel times the church. Amen. And what happens in the church depends on the local assembly. What happens in the local assembly goes depends on the believer. Amen. If you get that principle right, then you can start in Israel knowing exactly that that is natural, the spiritual is us. Amen. Now, in the natural, the series actually invented. Amen. Amen. Because they know the army that didn't invent it, this prophet. Amen. It didn't happen in Joel's day, amen. But Joel was at the time of Elijah, amen. It happened later on when they were going into Babylon, amen. Just before they were in Nebuchadnezzar, there was an invasion of the Syrian army. And the word of the prophet of Joel is not for, amen. It was accomplished in due time and upon the time, amen. But what will happen in between here, from the time that the prophet was being said, to attend that the prophet was bigger was there was a fall of Israel. Amen. That fall of Israel made the natural. What was the thing was that when they used to believe in the God of miracles, amen, they now had in Ahab. And with Ahab, Ahab had married to Jezebel. Amen. And when Ahab had married to Jezebel, they had a son. Amen. And the daughter, and the daughter's name was Atalia. Amen. And this daughter was called Atalia. She went and got married to the king of Judah, whose the kingdom had been separated. Amen. Now this daughter married to Jehoram. Amen. Jehoram was the king of Judah. Amen. The kingdom of Israel had been separated with one tribe being the king of Israel and another tribe being the king of Judah. Ahab was the king of Israel. Amen. So there was a lineage there. Amen. We will speak about that. We've spoken about it before, but we're going to talk about that lineage. Amen. And the Judah was the one that was focused in the element of Christianity. What is the kingdom of Israel now? For the people of Ahab, married to Israel. Amen. Atalia being the daughter of Jehoram, amen, she could make on the other side. Amen. But the prophet says when she got married, she brought in the religion of her mother Jezebel to the other side. Amen. Hallelujah. And with no time, her husband Jehoram died, and their son named Ahaziah took over. Amen. And Ahaziah, the Bible says, the two chronicles was going to only wound Ruth for 1 year. Amen. In that 1 year that Ahaziah wound, he went and over to the side of Israel, took counsel from his mother. And Athaliah was taking counsel from their mother, Jezebel. And when this was happening, there was a chant thing of the religion that Jezebel had in Israel, which was the worship of Baalism, into the other side of Judah. Amen. And that chant thing happened because Athaliah receiving the instruction from a mother to a daughter. Amen. She was a daughter, if I may excuse the expression, for the sake of our mixed audience, she was a daughter of a war. Amen. And being a daughter of a war, she became also a harlot. Amen. And because she was a daughter of a war, the expression of what war tongue that the mother did, she also was doing her own war tongue to the other side. Amen. And when she brought the other side, lo and behold, this is very important. Amen. The son has 1 year and died. And after she died, she did the most wickedness of all wickedness. He went and took of her son, who had been the next in line to take the throne, and he killed the royal seed. And when she was doing that, she had a motive. She had this marriage had been incited by Jezebel for political gain. They wanted political gain. It was never a gain that they wanted to proclaim the religion of Christ or of the Lord. But they wanted political gain. And because she was now, as the son had died, the mother Jezebel told her, now we can have this political gain. Kill all your grandchildren. And she killed all her grandchildren, except one who was her husband. The husband's sister went in and took Joash. And he took Joash and he hid Joash in the temple. Yes. How did the Joram do that? Because their husband was right at the high priest. So she took this child and hid him in the temple. And for 6 years, this wicked woman called Athaliah reigned in Israel. There's never been a queen reign in Israel, except this one. Amen. And during those 6 years, she ruled wicked. Because no longer was she now having a son who she could instruct. She was sitting on the throne and she was doing wicked thing after wicked thing. Now, what the prophet said was that it was the transfer of Jezebel religion from the mother harlot into the harlot. It was the transfer of the religion of Catholicism from Roman Church into the denominationalism. Amen. When Luther came up, Luther's reformation was not a Christian reformation. They did that for political gain. Amen. And when they did that for which that's in the church ages, they did it. Amen. When they did that for political gain. Okay. That political gain, the denominationalism that came up still had an element of Paganism, which was a worship of organization. Amen. So from Jezebelism, it went into the Reformation. In the Reformation, the Protestant Church still had an element of Paganism, organization. And it's there for the next 6 years. A type of the six church ages. Amen. There was this wickedness going on. Amen. And this wickedness was going on. Joash was then put as a priest. And then came up front. Amen. In 2 Kings chapter 22. And then the high priest proclaimed him to be king in the 7th year. A type of the beginning of the Laodicean church. And it was at this time. Here's where I want to make my point. The historian says was the time of the prophet Joel. At this time, at the time of the prophet Joel's prophecy, knowing that in the 7th year, when this the former rain and the latter rain starting, amen. In this former rain and the latter rain starting, it's now a restoration. Because when he came, he destroyed all that the mother was doing. But then the great actually was doing, amen. And all the paganism and everything else. And it was now a time of restoration to Israel. And in this time of restoration, it was fulfilling the natural part of the prophets. I just wanted to go through that part of the prophecy, which said that was the natural part, was happening. It was happening. We shall see that it also touched the spiritual. The words were spoken. Amen. The spiritual ones, the church of the living God that started on the day of Pentecost, and it was growing up. Amen. It also was going to go through a fall, whereby it was also going to have this great army of locusts. Amen. The caterpillar, the locust, the caterpillar, and so forth, eating the church. Amen. And you know, the prophet said that when the church was invaded, it came through a spirit of Nicolaitans. Amen. That Nicolaitan spirit was to try to bring the church down. Amen. But it was having a restoration in the seventh year, in the seventh church age. Amen. Then the time of the restoration is the time of the former and the latter rain. Amen. So now we are in the time of the former and the latter rain. Okay, let me go back now to where I want to go. Amen. I swear the Lord now. Amen. 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 Brother, amen. 1909. Amen. Brother, the message to the Pentecostal that was listening to church. Amen. They did not receive him. Amen. And because they did not receive him, he is a greater work to do than just being a message. He is a part to play of the restoration. Amen. And in this part to play of the restoration, he wants to bring the church back to what it was at the beginning. In the days of the apostles. Amen. Because the scripture prophet sent forth to turn the heart of the children back to the faith of the fathers. Amen. Okay. Now, Brother Branham maybe spent a lot of years with the Pentecostals and come to a point where the Pentecostals were now almost not accepting his message, because when he was among his dead, he would speak about Christ crucified in the healings. But when he would come back to his own church, he would speak about what he believed. Amen. And when he spoke about what he believed, the Pentecostals would get healed because it was the way of God. Amen. Now, here's what it is. Amen. In the message, Papa Web Locus under Kanga Web and Caterpillar, 19, or paragraph 19. And it so happens that your church doesn't believe, or you don't believe that the thing that we speak of is our church doctrine. We thought that it would by no means be an offense. Because the very first step to successful Christianity to show that the man is deceived with the Holy Spirit is humility. Real God given humility. That must be given humbly. Yet a church without a doctrine is just like a jellyfish. It has no backbone. Amen. God will say, come again, come with teaching. Amen. The teaching of the doctrine, what you believe in. So we're going to have a backbone in it. Not also a backbone, but it is also, because the church of God must eat the bread of life. Amen. And in paragraph 20, and we, in some of the statements that I make, if I try to drive it down, now please do not misunderstand. But when I want to put himself a disclaimer, that what is going to be preaching in these messages is going to drive his heart down hard. Amen. And to show forth his faith, his conviction, what he believes in. Amen. Show forth where he said. Amen. But I'm not meaning to be wrote on lecturing on the Bible. Amen. I know that each church has its own creed. I do not want to interact with that. But I'm only trying to bring out the scripture and make it with the scripture. So that all who understand that it isn't to be rude. It's just to be with love and affection and with mercy and the best that I know how to explain the scriptures. Amen. Sometimes when you are splitting up a church and you're starting, you want to stand up for your own conviction, which you've seen that it ties to the Bible from Genesis to Revelation. Amen. Not only to Revelation, but to the word was revealed by the spoken word too. Amen. Because you cannot be a faithful that are saying but something you believe in and you don't have a better one. And when you stand for it, you stand for it, and you have to drive it hard. Amen. Here we believe in the in baptizing water baptism in the name of Lord Jesus Christ. By immersion, the whole body once. Amen. That will take heart. Amen. We believe in the true genuine baptism of the Holy Ghost. Amen. That will drive heart. Amen. We believe that there's only one God that will drive heart. Amen. Our bed. Amen. And so many others that we believe in who will not compromise on any part of the Word of God that we teach here. Amen. If our statement, if our thing be contrary to the Word of God, amen, then everybody, anybody, like to say, look, but here, you are saying this, but this is contrary to this. Amen. And then we also yield ourselves. We believe that we are led by the Word of God. Amen. We've got no authority of a man. Amen. Whether it be a pastor or a five-fold ministry that comes over here or me or anybody, if they say anything contrary to what Paul says, we have a right to go and ask them, but that is not what Paul says. That is not exactly what the Word of God says. We may not do so publicly, but we will meet outside. Amen. But we want to go with the Word of God. Amen. So that the Word of God has got authority over us. Amen. Anyway, I've got a few things. I think I'm in time. Now, in the church this morning, this afternoon, I was saying, I want to explain why I believe what I believe. Amen. Now, we are coming to a serious sort of subject here. Now, I believe that there will come a time of the restoration of all things that has been done wrong. Amen. Now, you can tell when the brother was saying this message, it wasn't just a simple message, it was a keynote message of what he believed in. And we are believers of the message of Mother and Hope. Amen. So in talking about the restoration, it is a keynote message of the message. Amen. In talking about what the former reign and the latter reign does, and the restoration of what happens, of what has been eaten, it is a keynote of what we believe in. And those things we will hold it down and drive it hard. Amen. To what we believe. Amen. Okay, let's go again. The church is moving too slow for the hour we are living in. There's something that's been wrong. Amen. This is the prophet saying in 1959 in the message, come on, locust, stand away with caterpillar. Amen. He's seeing what has been coming out from the Pentecostalism and the rains and the blessings and the outpouring of the Holy Ghost and the gifts and how they were manifesting, the tongues, the prophecy, the healings. He himself was also among the great evangelists that started a healing, divine healing across the world, amen. But yet still, he said, it was something that's going wrong. Amen. There was something more to than that. Amen. In the midst of the former reign and the latter reign, amen. In the midst of the blessing of the church day, amen. In the midst of this reign coming with the teaching and with the gospel, amen. Teaching reign is the moderate reign. The latter reign is the dynamics, amen. We have to have a balance of teaching and dynamics. Faith being the dynamics, moderate being the teaching. Amen. Hallelujah. And we spoke last time how two other servants had gone into the world, Oral Roberts and Billy Graham. One was faith oriented, Oral Roberts, and another was fundamental oriented, Billy Graham. And there, the one seed and shall live of that seed. Amen. But there was one that said in Abraham, of which Sarah had the blue kids. And produce a son. Amen. And the one that said in Abraham, did a sign and Abraham to show forth, amen, that there's another sin. And he said that one that said in Abraham was none other than really a man that stayed in the Word of God. Amen. To produce a bride that are going to be changed into a character. By the transformation of their old age or an old age into another youthful age. That will produce a son of God named Jesus Christ in people's lives. Amen. We want Jesus Christ to be produced in us. Amen. So that is our conviction. Amen. Let us continue. There's something that we're wrong. It brings us in this day at the near coming of Lord to sit down and study. See what's wrong and find the cause. You never find the cure till you find the cause. Now, Brother Brennan is showing it hard now. We may not have the time to go through everything, but we will take one part of it. Amen. In this former and latter reign in the restoration, we just want to focus on the power way. Amen. The next time we both give us grace, we'll focus on the locust and can't get away with the caterpillar. Maybe one this service or work today that I don't know. Amen?
Amen.
Right. The first thing, there's four different people there now. But there is actually one beetle in four different stages. Now, watch. All the beetle come for this gate, the tree of God. We call it a tree which was the church. Hallelujah. So, Brother Branham is saying these beetles, they came after a tree. And we call it a tree of God. But in reality, it is the church. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know that people are sometimes tied the tree. In the Garden of Eden, there were two trees. One was the tree of good and evil. Tied the serpent, the other one was the tree of life. Tied with Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now, let's picture a big tree of God's tree. Listen, it's bearing 9 spiritual gifts. They are hearing this. They are speaking in tongues. They are casting out devils. They are doing great works in preaching the unadulterated word of God. No denomination to tie them down. They are free doing a great work. Amen. This was the beginning of the church. Amen. The church was greater than the work of daily churches. There was a fulfillment of all the tree, having everything that is needed. Amen. And this is what we've been called up unto. Amen. Our standards for any church, for any believer, is Pentecost. We do not compare ourselves with any other churches, amen, whether now or in the past, amen. Our standard is Pentecost, amen. Because what Pentecost was established is Pentecost, it was laid down in certain order. What is established here, and we laid down in certain order, amen. That's our comparison, amen. It's very nice piece of it. They're hearing this, they're speaking that, they're asking how they would. They're doing great works, preaching the undoubted word. There's never a hybrid. Amen? Okay? The first was the come away. There is a little thing, just a little bit insect of the world. Now, before we just, let's go to chapter 1, verse 1. This scripture is very important. The word of the Lord came unto Joel, the son of Petuel. Hear this, ye old men. So this message that Joel is proclaiming, remember, it is twofold. One to the natural, which we've already spoken about. Now we are coming to the spiritual element of it. Amen. And he said, hear you old men. It's never was the young that was given this attention, first of all. But it was the old men. And we have to talk again with the old, not coming to the realization of what this message really is. And then he says, give here all you inhabitants of the land. So this message is to everybody in the inhabitants of the land. Amen. There's a special attention to the old. But then old, they've seen something before. If this begin your days, even in the days of God, they're being called upon what they did see when the church was being inhabited. They had an original Pentecostal experience in their day. Amen. But now it's being told that this experience that we had, look at it now. Is it still happening? Tell your children of it. And if your children tell their children, and their children are not finished. So they found the time that they were fathers and would tell their children. Now in Deuteronomy chapter 29, verse 29, Mark, this is a very good scripture. Amen. That which is a secret belongs to God. But that which is revealed belongs to your children and your children and to other children. Amen. So everything that God has revealed belongs unto us and to our children and to our children and to another generation. And here, God said, tell your children. To children in the faith and children in the natural, God will come and God will bring this message. Amen. Now, verse 4 says, that which the palmer way is left. Is the locust eating? The locust is left. Is the cankerworm eating? The cankerworm is left. Is the caterpillar eating? Amen. In another Bible translation,
That means the chewing. It chews. The locust eating. The locust is the swarming. The swarming locust that the kangaroo is eating is a crawling locust. And that means the kangaroo is a caterpillar eating, is a consuming. Now, this is just one animal that goes in four different stages. The first stage of this animal, it chews. It's an animal that evolves. It is in the palm away, it chews. It goes on the tree back and it's chewing. Then it evolves at a period of time. Some of you young people, you are going to it in your geography or that. We did this thing in agriculture, beginning of the day. Amen. It evolves and then it comes. Like it can fly, like flying locust, and it can swarm. And they go to the trees and then they do something. And then after some time, it evolves and it starts to crawl on the tree branch. Amen. And then after some time, it evolves and it gets the root of the tree inside it. But that's one animal. Amen. And that animal, we've been told by Brother Branham, that it was none other than the devil who was creeping into the church. Amen. As he kept into the church, he came with this tree, with these four stages. Amen. Now, this, why we are having to bring the attention of the children and the children into their generation is because it brings a death. And in the church ages, it also brought a death to the church of the living God. Amen. But then, during that process, God promised a restoration of the church of the living God. And we as a Christian to know that what tells Israel, what tells the church also tells you as an individual. So we should be aware of how the devil comes unto us. I was educated as an individual devil. And it comes into our lives and it tries to destroy the faith of what has been laid in us. So that is seen within the tree of life, within the tree of God, can also be a type of you and I. Hallelujah. Amen. Let's continue. Amen. I think I've got a few more minutes. I'll close in a few minutes. I know I'm late. I've read so much. We'll get to where we need. Amen. I wanted you to take note that this message, Palm Away, Locust, Hunter Away, and Caterpillar was a keynote message. Amen. Let's now get to where we need to go. We are only going to focus on the Palm Away for today, focus on the others on another day. Now, in the message, the restoration of humanity, the first was the Palm Away. A little thing, a little bit inside of a worm. Did he do that to come away? He came along to destroy the fruit of the tree. That's the first thing. Take note. When the church of the living God was started, it is all the manifestation of God in the local church. Nine spiritual gifts, divine miracles, signs, and wonders. That was the church. The church is it is tied in the individual, it also means that the individual is also the nine fruits of the spirit. Love, joy, peace, long suffering, gentleness, amen. Found in Galatians chapter 5, this 21, and so forth. Amen. Because as a Christian, you're going to bear fruit in life. And the life that you bear fruit is going to be made manifest for others to see. Amen. And that life that you bear was the life of Jesus Christ. And the life of Jesus Christ was a life of compassion, of joy, of peace, of long suffering, of gentleness. Hallelujah. When Christ came to the fig tree, he died of it. Amen. And then when he could not get the fruit of it, he said, get me that tree. Amen. When Christ came to the individual, he died of the fruit of the tree to a believer. Amen. He's not looking for any one of these. Oh, I'm a great man. Hey, I'm puffed up. Hey, I've got great words. Hey, I've got great money. Well, I'm an office bearer. Hey, I'm a preacher. I'm a great preacher. He's not looking for that. Amen. The first thing that he
is the identification that a man has got the Holy Ghost is humility. Amen. What comes with that humility is the life of Jesus Christ and the fruit thereof. Amen. So in this history, while the Pharaoh was eating the church, it was eating the fruit of the church. The fruit of the church was the nine spiritual gifts. Amen. The fruit of the believer was the last joy in the peace. Amen. But see what this Pharaoh does. Amen. The first thing that was to destroy this. Amen. So in come to this little old devil, setting up his two horns, setting out in front like a grasshopper, you know, in this little old pretty thing. That's his first, the power. He came in to eat off brother Elah. Amen. Because Elah is one of the fruits. Amen. He says, you know, so did so over it, so check. I wouldn't believe that bunch of people. Now, what is the power doing? He's got a target. He wants to bring divisions among his brethren. Amen. It is an abomination to bring divisions among the brethren. So what does he come and do? He comes and tells one of the brethren, you know, so-and-so did so in that church. So if that so-and-so did so error, I wouldn't believe what that church does. Amen. Don't fellowship with them. Do not go to their church. Amen. What is happening? He's bringing divisions among the church. Amen. And so many people do not get to realize that this gospel was never called to bring divisions among the church. Amen. Not by any denomination and never in this message of the hour. We do not believe that we are divided. We believe that we have one faith, one baptism, and one court. Amen. We may be different in the way that we approach it. Amen. But we are of the same faith. Amen. Who will not say, don't go to that church. Don't go to that church. Amen. Who says, let's fellowship one to another. If you meet a bone, then take the bone, put it aside, eat the church pan. Amen. Hallelujah. I've often gone to so many fellowships, amen, for my youth, and I've many things which talk with me. And I said, for that I do not understand. I pray that the Lord be yes to understand it. I'll put that aside, and I will not follow, go along. I'll eat this. Amen. But then if that just continuously goes on in error, then I might wonder whether they are of the same faith, of the same baptism, of the one faith. Amen. Different. They're not of like conscious faith. Amen. But if they are of like conscious faith, I will not counter. Amen. People. Amen. Amen. And we don't teach this. Don't go that. Don't go that. Don't go that. No. We want people to have brotherly love. The moment we remove brotherly love among the people, we are removing one of the fruits of the restoration of the church. And because we are removing the fruit of the tradition, our life will not come to the full manifestation of Christ. Amen. There it is. First thing. That's the prophet. That's not me. He wanted to eat on the fruit of faith, the same family. Faith in the way of God. Hallelujah. The prophet is identifying what this family does. The family knows that the believer's life is a strength. Is based upon faith. Faith is the victory. Amen. But that faith is not faith, amen. It's not faith in another church. It's faith based on what the word of God says. Now, the word of God is God Himself. In the beginning was the word, and the word was with God, and the word was God. Amen. So if God is for the word, God is His own interpreter of His word. When He says, let there be, no man could have stopped. He might have talent, amen. The manifestation of this great thing, let them be, was what he has said to come to pass. So God interprets his own way by making sure that his way comes to pass. And we know that the believer of the way believes in the word of God, the word of God is saying, will come to pass. And that is faith that the believer has, the word of God, if it's taken away, their strength is taken away, amen. Like right now, we believe in the restoration of the bright sheep. Amen. We believe that whatever the candle was eaten, the caterpillar, the candle was the caterpillar, God said he's going to restore. Amen. Everything. But if our faith is going to be told that when he is restoration, he will restore that element of the way he's not going to restore. That's a power trying to take our faith away from the word of God. Amen. The word of God promises unto us as believers that mother therefore shall turn the heart of the children into the faith of the fathers. Amen. And if that is coming to pass within us, then they said, no, if the fathers were doing that, that was only for the apostolic age. It was never for the age time message. The word of God clearly says that that is what the believers should be. Amen. It is the power of them trying to take away a fruit from us. So the restoration of this fruit is now, as I'm preaching now, to let you know that this power of them is a trick. He wants to take away your faith in the word of God. He wants to take away your brotherly love. Amen. But God is restoring as this message is going forth. Amen. This message of Mother therefore is bringing back. Hallelujah. Pentecost. Hallelujah. And that is our foundation here. That is the foundation of every other place that we set this fellowship in order. Amen. How do you know that it is the way? It's been translated so many times. That is what we have is trying to say. Hey, how do you believe that this God is going to take this promise? And if you say there's a rapture, how do you know it's going to happen to you with all the life that you live? That's it, God said so. In the tricking of a knife, you said that you are going to be changed. Are you going to be changed for sure? Yes, I will. Amen. If God said so, amen. God will make it come to pass. Hey, with so much what is happening in the bride, you think there will ever be a church which is spotless? Yes, it will be there. And you could, amen. There's a quote that Brother Brian said, you will never, amen, make it come to pass. It will take the Holy Ghost to bring the church into a unity and to that spotless bride. Amen. No man can do that. Only God. Amen. Yesterday, the day. Amen. We all shall come back in the word of God and all shall be united with the word. There will be a spirit, remember. And in that spirit, people will be eager to hear the Holy Ghost. Amen. They will forget about all their new differences. Amen. They will want to hear that brother in love back in the bread. They will want to hear that faith in the way back in the bread. That will be so precious. As it dwindles away in so many, but to the next bed of Jesus Christ, they will want to have the full manifestation of the restored state of the living God. God said so, and it shall come to pass. Amen. We believe that here, my life preached it, and we are destroying that man. Amen. Oh, now there's another fruit as we come to our close now. We are almost there. Amen. There's another fruit we think of the joy. No, the devil just says, shh, don't say amen, shh, don't say hallelujah, shh, don't you speak, you're making too much noise. When this gospel was first inaugurated, you think you would have kept the Peter the John on the tail of Philip when they were scattered. Amen. They made such a commotion coming out from the upper room. And they were speaking in tongues, hallelujah. And the people that were hearing from different people, different nations, and they were hearing in their own languages. And then, how big it is, it's only by the morning of the day are these people drunk? Hallelujah. What was causing the commotion was noise. People rejoicing with the power of Holy God. And the church of the living God has been called to bring the joy back into the church. Amen. It's time for the stimulation that has been promised by the return of the former and the latter day come back into the church. The wine, hallelujah. And the people say, hallelujah, joy, amen, amen. Do not let the devil ever make you must keep quiet when you believe the word of God. Amen. There's a special thing that I've always said. The place that I love to be is on the hallelujah street, amen, corner. Joy Avenue.
Amen.
That street I really love. Amen. That's my place. That's my position. When I'm hearing the word of God in the such thing, hallelujah, amen, joy. I can't stop me. Amen.
Amen.
You will know that I've reached my goal. I once went to a church, a Pentecostal church, in Chamber Road. There was a Pentecostal church by the garage. We passed through it. What that church for? That was only church of God, amen. It was a Pentecostal church, amen. I go there, like sometimes you don't have money, you don't know where to go, you just sit in the church. I walked in, and I was sitting in the church in that church. My sister used to go to that church, amen. She was great, sister better. Probably she's streaming in that church, amen. And then as I said in that church, the gospel was heard, amen. You know what? They were actually preaching the true gospel, amen. And I was already listening to him. I was waiting for him to be able to hear. Amen. But I couldn't afford to be able to hear. Amen. Then I went to that church and I was believing in the message. I was this when I was preaching, I was preaching. Amen. And then I just, as I said, amen. 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 And then God, within no time, I was seeing people say, who is that person? Amen. Because I go to my corner. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. They become so quiet. The prophet that never what is here. Okay. So this little old God gives me the food of joy. Now look, even you people make too much noise. That's what it is. I tell you, all this crying, this amen, this shouting, that there's nothing in that. That's the little system we need to get. Amen. The first thing you know, you set a big box there. All of them, some of those increased so-called doctrine of kids pumping have been with the Spirit of God ought to be learning with all church kids pumping there. They are icy and cold. Usual thermometer, light tech goes zero. Yes, somebody said, amen. Everybody says they are neck around that some kind of a boost or something. Amen. That is what they mean. Amen. I was saying, amen, and never was thinking of. They couldn't understand it, amen. But all the joy of salvation, hallelujah, that was a spiritually dead condition. That's why the food had been taken away from their identity. When God gives an individual, hallelujah, restoration, one of the food of the spirit is joy. Joy in the Lord, amen. And I always joy is an acronym of Jesus, others, and yourself, amen. Hallelujah, when you have the joy of the Lord, you have so much love of God, amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Okay, let's rush off. Then to another. Oh, the prophet says, yes, that's definitely the concept says, give me the joy. Lord, restore unto me the joy of my salvation. Amen. His salvation wasn't taken off. It was only the joy. I never did say those people, they were spiritually dead, that their salvation is taken off. That just didn't have the joy. Amen. If they had the joy, they would have their salvation in the world. Amen. And what we pray to bring back to the fellowship that we believe in is the joy of our salvation. It is what is the palm of our kids. Amen. So when you have some people saying that you should not enjoy this message, this gospel, you should know it's the palm of it. We are meant to be enjoying this message. If we didn't enjoy it, we won't be here.
Amen.
We can because this message is fixed to us. Amen. It's got joy that brings to us. Amen. Oh my, I'm just worried for the time now. And then next on the tree is peace. The peace of mind. Amen. Knowing that you are saved. Amen. So many people are saved. They believe that they've been saved. Then the next thing will do one other thing. And then God gives them less enough to come back. And then they do not forgive themselves. And then they are no longer in peace. God has already forgiven them, but they cannot forgive themselves. And then they bind themselves by themselves, not to God. Amen. God has already given them that space of salvation. Amen. And then they are caught up because of their own guiltiness. They were sorrowful and repentant, but they didn't. They are killed. What I've been sorrowful, Lord, will you come and take away the guilty feeling and give me the peace of God? And they do go in and out of the churches, but they are bound in their own bondage of lack of peace. When Jehovah Shalom, amen.
Amen.
Jehovah Shalom wants to restore the peace in you and I. Amen. And when you got the peace, we are blessed. Amen. We are free. We are liberty. We can fellowship with brethren. Amen. We don't have this element of saying, I'm the only old one out among his them here. We are just like everyone else. We are all saved by the grace of God. And God makes us one seed, amen. All of the same thing. Whether we've been in the message for how many years, or you've just come today, we become the same, amen. Hallelujah. So many of the old timers think that they are above the others. No, glory to Almighty God. But this one, they tell you now: if you reject your church, that's it. If you join my church, that's it. Now. Listen, you are not safe if you go there. If you come to a church, you say, oh, that's it now. We are the only ones that said this. But the only one that will tell this gospel, if you call me that one there, you are not going to be saved. You will not have your restoration. You will not have the restoration of your full church. Because there, and then they will claim that you have drunk that year. And the man in Matthew chapter 24 says, when he says, no, he's here, or no, he's there, do not go after them. Amen. Because no gospel of Jesus Christ will point the believer to another church. That is what I tell you as doctrine man in the denominationalism. Amen. Instead of pointing people back to Christ, that denominationalism was pointing people to power, to another false doctrine, to another whole term. Amen. Instead of telling people to be a Christian, but to believe the word of God and to trust in the word of God, not to trust in a church. Even this church, amen. We don't trust that the God is here, it's not based. We know we forget that when you come here, it's just an error to gather so that you may move from here and go into the word of God. But just to be in God Himself. So we don't say, for you to be saved, you've got to come to our fellowship. We said you've got to believe the word of God wherever you are. Amen. Amen. Whether here or there, amen. Believe on the word of God Himself. You say, hell me, you've got to put your name on this book, you've got all man. You take all the joy out. Imagine this, what this we said that was the power of that in the early churches, amen. When they split the churches, amen. We did that in this latter day as well, amen. When people were saying that for you to be saved, you see the message, you see the message. We're pointing more people to the message and the gathering of the message instead of pointing people once they receive the message. Take it further to receive Christ Himself. Well, the message was also corrupted by other people that were not necessarily believers, that were power ones. Amen. So you cannot claim and compare yourself to a brother, to a sister. You want to compare yourself to a word of God. Hallelujah. Oh, no, I'm saying that. But it's true anyhow. Amen. You know what my story about the new? Okay? He's a happy. You know who his papa or mama is the one was? He's at all a good technique. He was born who his papa and mama was two generations. But the Bible is talking about the new that he is not of a horse, neither is he of a donkey, but is a hybrid. Amen. The donkey and the horse, and then they get a new, and that new can do great work for friends. And the thing that they need is for that of two pedigree things. Whenever you have a high project, think like amen. When you have the church at Nancy Cantor, what came out of it through the doctrines of Atalia and Jezebel seems to be so good. The thing that we are doing is a church. So we get people to be Christians, we'll give people power, we'll do missionaries, we'll build schools, we'll build hospitals, good works. Amen. It was a Bible. Amen. But a pure pity was born who his father and mama was. He knows that what I am is what my papa and my mama are. Amen. What my papa and mama produce is what I will produce. A pure pedigree Christian who wants to produce what was produced at Pentecost. And at the Pentecost, if they were told to repent, he will repent or she will repent. First thing, be baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Don't be baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. God is duty obligated to be fully independent to give you the baptism of the Holy Ghost. Otherwise, God will lie. God cannot lie. Hallelujah. So if you do what God says, genuinely sincere, then you leave it in the hands of God, see whether God will not do it or not. I challenge you to be perfect. Amen. I've always got to challenge. If I've done it, what God said I should do, I have the obligation to God. And we need this foundation. We should go back to Pentecost. That's why I'm not comparing here with any other place. I'm not comparing to Pentecost. Amen. If we go back what Pentecost was, amen, we will receive the outcome of what Pentecost did. Not Pentecost as an organization, Pentecost as an experience of receiving the Holy Ghost, the genuine Holy Ghost. Amen. Remember to end now. Amen. You could educate Christian to. God, the Holy Ghost, you know it fell on the day of Pentecost. He knows where he's at. He can trace his generation and come back His genealogy is with the first beginning, like Islam. Peter ate it. On down to the nation of races, they ate it. On down, a good pedigree Christian knows where it comes from. There is an it there that Peter ate. Down the generation, there has been it there. And here in 2021, we also have to have it here. The full distortion of what God is going to do. The power of the religion, that's what we want back. Amen. God promised a restoration of all the things that was in the church. Not Christ, all.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So we have seen what the power went, where Brian was going to say, we can stand up on our feet. Because I was just not focusing on the power of him. Amen. Amen. Now notice, to old instead, started eating. But he ate of the peace of mind on and on and on and on, a good page of his year, all food what he done. So brother did not end the message. In the restoration of the bread, he actually says, I've got 5 pages on the food there. Amen.
Amen.
He left that part of the message for the fivefold ministry to take part, to take portion. There's more. There's the fruit of suffering alone. I call it suffering alone. The word of God is on, don't suffer. Amen. When you have to suffer alone with your brother and be gentle with your brother and have love for your brother when he's in error. Amen. But you know that God may give him grace. Amen. You speak to him gently and nicely and pray for him. Amen. Believing and trusting that God will bring you to that way. Hallelujah. There's a spirit of gentleness that you are not good. Amen. But you speak gently one to the other, comparing one another, in treating one is better than yourself. Amen. Hallelujah. With love. Amen. Those are the fruits that a believer should have, that the church should have. Amen. If we acclaim that God is going to restore and make us Christians, we have to pray for these things. Amen. We've got to pray that God restores this in the individual's lives. But there's only one way that this is going to be restored. How will they get it in the first place? They depend it in the Lord Jesus Christ. And they cry for the Holy Ghost, and God gives them the Holy Ghost. Amen. So it is no longer we that are just claiming it. Otherwise, if you claim it, you can be like a Christian sign that I'm far than we have. But this old flesh, they're trying to do it. We do not want to just try to do it. For this of his own kind, the word of God was laid in us. This former moderate reign, teaching reign, also comes with a seat, which is the word of God, which is being led. And the blessings of the former and the latter reign, this seat of God was of his own kind. As we go ahead. Amen. I truly, genuinely believe God is restoring. Hallelujah. He is coming. And this message of this day and hour is going forth. Spend time to listen to the message. Spend time to go through. And I would like you, for them that might be well acquainted with this series, to go back to this message, the Palmer Worm. Caterpillar cankerworm in 1959. There's the other one in 1959. Amen. I'm going to ask Brother Amos to come and pray for us. Amen. As he leads us in prayer, each one of us also pray for our own accord. Amen. I believe God. I believe God. Even as he said, I said, no, babe, look up and say, I believe God, he shall be done.
Beautiful,
even as it says, trust and obey, look up and say, I believe God.
Yes, I believe God, all things shall be done. Oh, hear and stand, trust and open. Oh, look up and say,
message that we can go into our hearts, that we be looking out for this kingdom. Back over the palm of the locust, come to take away the things that would prosper us, but we shall restore this time. Lord, the light has come, and that time of restoration is our life. That's right. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord God Almighty, we thank you, Lord, for your word. Thank you, Lord God Almighty. Oh God, I tell you, Lord, hear the true word of God. Lord Almighty, you spoke to us through our Lord Almighty, touching us by our Lord. Lord Almighty, by your divine participation, that in this day, Lord, our heart, we take back all our ways to the faith of our Father and Father. Lord Almighty, at this time, Lord Almighty, Lord Jesus, may we be, let our hearts be healed, Lord. Thank you, Lord Almighty. Thank you, Lord Almighty. Installation, Lord Almighty. Exhortation of the word, Lord Almighty. Thank you for the time for Lord Almighty. Doing the word of Lord Almighty at this time, Lord Almighty. Coming in with the spirit of life, Lord. Open our hearts, Father.
Thank you, Lord, for the message.
And then the sisters also were coming with their song. And the songs, you can see the excitement. So some of them that stayed to hide out. Amen. Amen. That's all the gifts from the church. Amen. We've got the sister Julia, Brother Judah, Nigeria. Unfortunately, they've been put up in the announcement and they could not get flights. So each one of them, if they come directly to UK, would have to pay £2,000 each. Quite a lot. We do not want that. Not that I'm very contrary because of the government. I just pray that move.
Amen.
And it was too
old.
Amen. I'm a lower faith. But God will do something. And it's true. The name of God. Amen. Yes.
Amen.
The possibility is one more.
Amen.
Let's pray for them. Amen. Not only for their coming back, they're going for a wedding, but they've been waiting just Saturday, but they are also preparing their wedding. The dates and so forth are not yet announced, but they're checking for a location. They've actually found a location. They found the location and the date of it, but the finances is to pay for the location. Payment order. So we'll keep that to them until they are ready, because it's otherwise. But please just pray for them that they have enough resources to get this book. And then we believe that that happens. Then we can start preparing for all that comes along. Pray for their work, that the work center specifically has been received. Amen. As for the process. Amen.
Heavenly Father, Lord Jesus, we are so grateful, Lord, this afternoon. We want to thank you, Lord, for speaking to us in such a manner, Lord. We want to thank you, Lord, that we've been fed, oh God, due season, oh Heavenly Father. Almighty Jesus, help us, Lord. May you write, Lord Father God, your word in the scrolls of our hearts, Lord, so that we might remember it, Lord. Heavenly Father, help us, Lord Father God, to have all that you want us to have within us, oh God. All the spiritual, Lord Father God, gifts, Lord, all the spiritual, Father God, that we are meant to have within us, oh God. Lord, we pray, may you help us, Lord. Father God, if there be anything that wants to get rid of that, Heavenly Father, we bind it in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Father God, help us, Lord, to manifest Christ, Lord, as we walk, Lord, Father God. Help us to walk with you, Lord, each and every day that we live, oh God, so that the world might see you, oh God. Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord. Even as we depart, Lord, we pray, may you go with us, oh Heavenly Father. Lord, may you guide us throughout the week. May you fight all our battles. May you provide, Lord, all our needs. We pray, Lord, even for those who are online, Father God, help them, oh God. Heavenly Father, may you grant them the desires of their hearts. We thank you, Lord. We worship your name. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. We come to the end of our service. We sing this song. Amen. We're late today. I'm so sorry. I'm taking the habit of our prophet. It's sometimes late. It's late. Amen. But I pray God has helped me not be late. Amen. I left things for the last minute. Amen. Each time we're trying to get out, something new will come in. May God help me over time. Our church here, we want to leave at the start at 11:30, although we are allowed to come and set up at 11. If we set up at 11, we'll make it at 11:30. But if we set up at 11:30, it means 12. Amen. So we are long past 30 minutes. Amen. For those online, we are sorry. Time that we might have taken you, but I believe this message was upon my heart. Amen. Let's take the name of Jesus. Amen. In the name of Jesus, we do. Lord, sorrow, and
Thank you so much.